and this a dagger n can be shown to be square root of this times n k plus 1. So this would give me square root of n k plus 1 times delta of n prime of k n of k plus 1. Actually, the best thing to do it is to do simple one-dimensional harmonic oscillator or do a double oscillator in quantum mechanics, and you will find exactly same similar relations, and they are directly with the extension that here now they carry momentum dependence. That's it. So you have all these things in field theory. So we sensibly in a simplified manner, we can keep using this entire technology for generating this and one more, which is the, otherwise you would not be able to obtain the higher Fock states. Means you have vacuum, then ground state. Vacuum is the ground state, then one particle state, two particle states, three particle states, and the same thing you do here in string theory. I mean, particle is replaced by one dimensional object. So here it is this simple looking relation. It operates on this to give you zero. A dagger operates on vacuum to give you one particle state, but of course you make it momentum dependent. So this is one particle with some momentum level k, and then you can calculate, let me write it here, n of k, this you can write a dagger of k raised to the power n of k divided by n of k factorial square root of k into this. So making you in field theory, you would, how would you write it in field theory in more properly? I mean, this is a symbolic representation, but a more proper representation is particles with momentum k1 and particles with momentum k2 and particles with momentum ki. This is equal to 1 divided by n of k1 factorial n of k2 factorial, and this whole thing raised to the power half times a dagger k1 to the power n of k1 a dagger of k2 to the power n of k2 etc. and 0. So you can, using this, you can calculate one particle state, two particle state, three particle state. It depends on your interest and courage, how much you like to go. And I think before I go there, could I take another just couple of minutes to tell you a difference of bosonic and fermionic systems. If you like, I do it other time. If you like, I do it just now. So here, we have determined that this is the n particle state, which you can construct by applying annihilation repeatedly and creation operators on the vacuum state. Okay, you, for one particle state, you operate on it one creation operator, for two particle state, yet another time, and you can create a n particle state on this. Okay, it looks complicated, but it's not. Okay, it's a simple thing. Now, let me because I'm talking about the let me just tell you one very important basic difference of, so this was boson, okay, bosonic operators, the four-way communication relations. So AB is AB minus BA, and if they commute then it is zero. So, but for fermionic operators, so in bosonic operators, A of K and A dagger of L, they commute and they have a delta K, and this is bosonic, okay. And for fermionic, you have A of K, A dagger of L, the anti-commute. So this is the only difference. When A and A dagger are fermionic, these K and L are momentum levels, okay. Then they anti-commute, where anti-commutation relation of AB is AB plus BA. Now here, as a consequence of this, you will find that A of K and A of L, the anti-commute, A dagger of K, A dagger of L, the anti-commute, and this implies that AK square is 0 and A dagger K square is also 0. If you put K equals to L, then A K dagger AK dagger plus AK dagger AK dagger twice, right? So as a consequence, supposing you are assuming now that they anti-commute, which is the case that will be true for fermionic string or the super string, they would anti-commute, so then this would be 0, which means, and I put K equal to L, then AK into AK plus AK into AK equals to 0. So AK square would be 0 and AK dagger square would be 0. Now, let us do a very simple calculation of N of K. Could I make some space here? Now, N of K square, this would be AK dagger AK times A K dagger AK. Now this is AK dagger, this is A dagger H your 1 minus A dagger K AK times A of K. This is equal to, now multiply it, so AK dagger AK minus AK dagger square times AK square. So this is 0 and this is 0 and this is back to N of K. So what I get is N of K square minus N of K, let me put 0 on this side, I take it to this side, so N of K square minus N of K, or N of K square, N of K I can take common, N of K minus 1, right? I am just calculating nk square, I took it to this side, nk square minus nk, this should be 0. Only if I assume that A and A dagger, they anti-commute, they are fermionic and they anti-commute. If that happens, then A into A dagger is not 1 plus but 1 minus, okay, 1 minus A dagger. Now they anti-commute, so this is 0 and this is 0. Is this okay? a into a square plus a into a square, 2a square equal to. So 2a and 2a ke dagger square equal to 0. So the entry component. Now I want to apply the state vector nk square minus nk. I want to apply the nk to this. This would be n. This would be, or let me put n a square minus n k times the state vector k. This would give me the same value. So little n k square minus little n k times the vector n n k. This gives me n of k minus 1, and this we remember is equal to 0. Even when we apply this state vector here, this is 0, which means this is 0, which means this has two values, n k is 0 and n k is 1. Earlier, when we had commutation relations for A and A dagger, which was the bosonic case,